This is the new retail version of the Orgone Acummulator with a version 2 firmware. Check out my first video by clicking the link in the video and in the video description to check out the main features, but really quickly we'll skim through those. The core of the oscillator is built up around a PWM sub output and a main output. Now the PWM sub, a nice fat square which we can modulate the PWM of with the index control. The main output is built around 3 wavetables, and we select which wave we want. On each one. Some traditional waves, some more noisy waves, more organ-like tones. And the third one, let's say noise. We can then crossfade between those waves. And we've got attenuverters for most controls as well. So an LFO will scan through those. Keeping that static and just on a sine, we've got AM modulation. We can turn up the depth of modulation on the index and the frequency on the frequency control. You can see on the oscilloscope that AM modulation on that sine. This comes from a modulating oscillator which has its own wave. Obviously a different modulating wave carries a different tone. We can change this into FM modulation, simply with the FM button. And then the frequency of the FM. Again, and a waveform selection for that modulating oscillator. We can fix that modulation frequency rather than it following the volt per octave. This works on all the waves. So that's the basic principle of it. The first version of the Orgone Acummulator is based around having a detune effect. Now, several new effects in a drum mode, which is what we're going to look at in this video. We choose the effect by hitting select and pressing 1 of 8 buttons. And the first effect is that same detune. We've either prime ratio detune or a more normal detune of 5 different oscillators, and we turn those effects on per wave. So remember, we've got these 3 different waves indicated by this yellow LED. Let's turn on the effect for this middle waveform. So scan over to that. We get the detune. And that's a bipolar effect. Turn that back on for the first, say off for that one. And we've got a resetting, which works as a gate to sync our oscillator. Notice that extra bit of punch and clarity when the detune's in and we actually reset this per note. Have this on all the oscillators. So when we're modulating between our waves and crossfading, this detune effect carries through. But again, we can turn that off only on certain waves. The AM and the FM still work. Let's move on to another patch and look at the second effect. So let's look at that second effect mode, the twin oscillator mode. Press select and hit 2. You can see that was already flashing because I'd already selected this. And this is a twin pair of oscillators, and when you move the phase on the effect of the oscillators, we get these different wave shapes as these phases interact. You can see on that sine, when this first oscillator and the effect's on. When it's off, nothing happens. You see, I can start to affect that shape. And this is quite a low pitch sound, so you might not hear that. So let's move the effect off and move to a more rich waveform. It's a bit easier to listen to. Roundabout saw wave. Let's turn that on. So you can adjust these phases. Under CV control with an LFO, we'll get some really great detune sounds. This up to audio of it. Super crunchy gnarly sound. Let's go back down to an LFO and trim that attenuator. Again with that effect off. Select different waves, so turn the effect on for all of them, scan through, and have the modulated phase. You can use this without modulation, just to create new shapes. It still work with the AM. And FM. So even with the FM, we can change that shape. Also modulate that. So by modulating the scanning, you can modulate each of the three waves, the AM or the FM's depth and frequency. You can use this mode to create that extra phase shifting and detune sort of sounds as well. So we're in that third effect mode, which is the first distortion mode. And as these effects are bipolar, moving that effect to the left, we get a bit crush and downsample style sound. To the right, a wave folder. Got an envelope triggering a VCA, as I had in the first part of the video. Let's use a second envelope to trigger that effect amount. And as I don't have the effect selected on these waves, just the first, or all three. Still combine that with the AM. That's no effect. And then assigning the effect back to the first oscillator bank. Sweeping the frequency of the FM. FM off, AM. So there's lots of effects to explore. Now this is another distortion mode, and we've got XORable, which is XOR logic, exclusive OR logic based distortion, and another wave folded mode where the wave's folded back on itself. So let's assign the effect to that first wave select. Here's the folder. And the XOR XORable. am. FM. And an envelope to our effect amount. Our FM amount. And then add some of the effect back in. Loads of sounds to go out with those distortion, and remember, you can still scan these waves, change your modulation oscillator for the AM and FM, and then modulate this effect or the free waveforms themselves for the A, B and C wave select. So you can probably already hear we're in that fourth effect mode, which is the chords, and it's selected again, select and chords. Now if I zoom in, you can actually see on the panel some labelling to help you to see those different effects modes. So let's zoom in and take a look at that. Let's check out the different chord types with a few minor types. And some majors as well. And we can say modulate FM depth. So some nice bonus chords, great for those stacked house chords where we've got that chord memory style function that you get on maybe a Juno keyboard, stacked up harmony that you can use as chords within a patch. So we've got a slow envelope being triggered, just opening and closing a VCA. Let's go into that spectral effects mode, select and spectral. Okay, that kicks in a slight waveform change. Turn the effect on this first oscillator. And then we've got detune to the right. And then to the left, we've got cross mod. Nice bonus in this mode is that the modulating oscillator actually becomes a global wave selector for this cross modulation. So going to the full effect on what's a relatively simple wave to start with. Hear those extra overtones. Now we select the wave to modulate that. Detune as well. A chordal like tones in that one. Here's a seventh mode, the delay. So effect select and delay. Pure sine wave, effects currently off. Turn that on, and then the effect amount controls the feedback of a delay, positive or negative feedback. The frequency controls the delay time, the modulation frequency, and we've got a fixed waveform. Well, the mod knob becomes a modulation frequency. So turn up the delay feedback and delay time. And like some delay chips, you can sort of make this sort of conk out and actually stop. those into that sort of noise, let's patch some sample and hold in to modulate this delay effect. And we can change from a sine wave . That's an easy way to get some more reverberant and reflective textures, some nice slower drone type movement, or as I've done there, patching some random CV and start to create these more noisy modulations based on that droning oscillator underneath the delay effect. So we're now in that final effect mode, which is the drum mode. We start with a wave select for the core of the drum sound, a scan to go between two drum sounds, a decay for the first sound, and the amount of that envelope, the decay envelope, that goes to the pitch. So this is our decay, opening and closing our note, and that's just a low pitch FUD at present. Let's turn up the amount of pitch modulation. Hear a simple electronic kick sound. And as I said, decay for both of those, the amplitude, and the pitch envelope, controlled by B. Now pressing the button that would usually select the effect on and off for B adds an extra hold to that envelope time to open up the body and the weight under that sound. So let's listen to it without and with. I think that really fills the low end out. Moving over to the other oscillator, this is its decay, and the wave select, some more noisy, we then have a spread of this on multi-oscillator. And then a cross modulation between these oscillators. So really easily get noise, which is great. Want a nice tight noise. To go over kicks, so let's crossfade over. That's great for making snare sounds as well. Sticking with the first sound, we've got the waveform select for that as well. You see, this is great for loads of different drum sounds, and remember, we can modulate both the waves, the decay time, the amount of pitch envelope that we're getting, the cross modulation, and the spread all through the normal CV inputs. So I just pressed stop on the camera, thought let's patch up some kick snares and hi-hats as mentioned, and actually this is much more fun. There's loads of options for kick snares and hi-hats, and the Orgone will do all of those sounds. It's got its own quirks, its own little sounds for kick snares and hats, and more traditional electronic percussion types, but these glitches and all this more mangled percussion sounds is where it really excels. And if you've read the 5th issue of my magazine, DivKid's Month of Modular, You'll see in my interview with Jim from Neutron Sound that he's actually working on a drum module based on this drum mod with multiple voices, multiple drums that we can trigger at once. So the final new thing to look at, and again, go check out that first video linked in the description and again here on screen for the video, but the final thing to look at for this new retail version and the new firmware is the Pulsar mode. And this mode is based on a synthesis method proposed by Curtis Rhodes, first described in Sound Compositions with Pulsars. And basically, a pulsar is made up of a particle of sound, or a pulse lorette, which is shaped by an envelope whose duty cycle and frequency can be manipulated. So we turn the pulsar on that second button. And you can see those changes start to take shape. See those like little individual pulsarettes or pulses. Do get some differing tones with the different wave shapes. What's great in this mode is we can still go in and turn the effects on. First effect, the detune. All the other effects and selecting the effects works the same. You can just come in and out of pulsar mode. Let's add some modulation and check out this pulsar mode under several bits of sampling hall modulation. This is just yet another sound generation method and another lot of modulation, turning pulsar off. We have the FM and some level modulation going on we've already seen. You can see these little pulses of sound. Let's put some detune effect on the left. So the Orgone Accumulator is absolutely packed with sound generation, manipulation and effects for creating a whole world of sounds, all which have just sat great in mixes that I've been doing, and bits of sample packs and things. They just seem to sit really well and sound sort of complete out of the box. As always, hit like and subscribe for more videos every week, and check the Patreon link in the description to see how you can support my channel.